Hello Gundam fans, this is Bram92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 Real Grade Assisting Weapon Aircraft from Susan Model, and at the model kit from Gundam Central. Link is in the description below. So, here is the actual aircraft. A very sturdy and solid aircraft. I was surprised at how well everything goes together. The Tamashii-like stand, not so tight. There's no screws, so it's very loose, but the actual aircraft is very good. It also comes with a little adapter, which I think is for the shield when you attach it to the new Gundam. And some waterslide decals, which is always nice to see. So, by itself, it's just an aircraft. The wings can move in and out. It looks cool. You got the main body is the shield, baskets, front skirts, leg armor, and then the cannon, the beam rifle, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, it by itself, it is kind of cool looking. But of course, it'll look way better once we connect it to the real grade New Gundam. And here's the real grade New Gundam heavy weapon system using the third-party upgrade parts. Now, it's not a simple swap, like a put-on connecting thing. You gotta like exchange a lot of parts. You got a lot of parts you have to take off the New Gundam. Like, you have to take off almost all the chest armor with the vent. You have to take off the front skirts, the back skirts, the one side of the navy blue calf armor, and, you know, you get rid of the shield and the old beam rifle. So, once you have it all together, though, it connects rather well. Aside from the leg thrusters, I had to glue them on, unfortunately. They would go on, but they wouldn't stay on well enough to actually, me not worried about them falling off all the time, so I just glued them on. A little bit of glue. The front skirts are a little loose going side to side. You can see that it's kind of floppy, but I really like the detail. The matching with the gray looks pretty good. It does have little extra details like the chest armor here. You've got flip-up pit missiles, which I like. They even colored the missiles differently from the gray going into the armor, which is cool. The chest panels can come off sometimes, just gotta be careful. The front skirts do have manipulator arms, which I love. They come with a side and they flip forward, and they do have little grabby claws, which would be able to hold a beam saber if you really want them to. I'm just really glad that they're there. They're very cool. Just gotta make sure you bend everything properly to get it back in. The baskets have some armor that can come out on the side and flip out extra thrusters. Leg armor doesn't do anything, it just looks cool. And the shield, which is also the Mega Beam Cannon, houses extra canisters for the new cannon it has. So you can, I guess, fire full beams at three times, I guess. And this thing here has an extending barrel, has an extending scope, and this little thing a little bit. It also has a tripod, which is painted very well and just comes down on some ball joints. So that's pretty cool too. Now yeah, this thing here comes off only because the connection on the sliding part of the arm for the beam saber has always been loose, I find, at least on mine. And that added connector that comes with the third-party kit definitely helps, because the shield does need to stick off farther to make sure it doesn't hit too much. Although it does hit the fin funnels because, well, it's so big. I mean, not much you can really do there. Just gotta hope for the best, really. And this thing is left off to the side, but this connects a lot of the parts for mobile armor. This goes over the beam cannon barrels. You put the front skirts on here, the leg armor here, and the, I think that's about everything. And then they also let you connect to the stand. So, yeah. And let's do a comparison with the high-grade New Gundam heavy weapon. I don't think I really want the, Bandai version now, because I really like the detail on this thing, and the fact that it can make a ship. If you're on the fence of getting, say, the new Gundam, or you couldn't find anywhere in stock, and you weren't sure if this thing, the third armor, would be in stock for long, get it. You'll have a cool ship to display by itself, and then when you get it, you can put on the new Gundam. But do be careful with the leg armor. You might have to glue it, and it might be permanent. And like I said, you do have to swap quite a few parts to get this to work. But it really looks awesome. I'm very, very happy with it. I think it's great. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.